So Tekashi keeps winning and people can't seem to understand why. Well, in this video, I'm going to explain the reason. So I think it's safe to say that this boy is not going anywhere anytime soon. So whether you like him or hate him, he is succeeding because he is doing things that other people around him have been unwilling or unable to do for a long time. And that is this: he is using his brain. Yes, let that sink in. He is using his brain. Takeshi is more intelligent than most people realize. He certainly is more intelligent than 99% of the people that are criticizing him. And here's why I say this, okay? He is smart enough to advertise himself right after coming out, right after being released, okay? He's smart enough to do a live explaining why he did what he did right after being released. I know he's still in house arrest and serving the rest of his sentence, but right after coming out, he decided to say it himself on video because he knew that that will draw more attention to him and to explain himself where no other attorneys or spokesperson is, speaking on behalf of him. But this is him talking to people by himself on video. That will draw attention. And then he's smart enough to release a single at the time when most of the attention is on him. These are very smart moves on his part, but it didn't really start there, okay? It started when he decided to affiliate himself with these G's. I try to keep my channel clean, so I'm not gonna use, you just have to decipher what I'm saying, and I try to make it obvious what I'm referring to. So when he associated himself with these G's in order to get some street cred and to promote himself and his music, that was an intelligent thing. He was using them from the beginning, just as much as these G's around him used him for money, because he was sponsoring them. He was giving them a lot of money, so both sides used each other. However, he knew when to check out. He knew when to say, "Okay, you know what? Enough is enough. This isn't working for me anymore. I am getting out of this." Regardless of what anybody thinks of him, regardless of whether or not people think, "Well, he doesn't really understand the streets and he didn't grow up in the streets. This isn't really him. He doesn't have the real street mentality and that is why he did what he did." No, the fact of the matter is he knew when to get out. And most of the people that are criticizing him do not know that. They don't know when something no longer serves them and they do not know when to say, "Okay, you know what? Enough is enough. I've had enough of this. This isn't helping me. It's not helping my situation. It's not helping my financial situation in any way. There is no reason why I should keep doing this. There's no real loyalty here, so I am getting out." And he is now affiliating himself with law enforcement by cooperating with them and by, following the rules that he's expected to follow. For instance, getting permission to release his music video. All of these things add up, like when you are acting this way, when you're doing what a judge asks you to do and you're obeying, the whatever rules they set forth for you, you do gain some respect in their eyes. So you're less of a target for law enforcement. And if people have not realized by now that if you are fighting on the opposite side of law enforcement, 99% of the time you will not win. Okay? So he's associating himself with the winning side, which, whether you like it or not, is law enforcement. Personally, I do not care for G members or people that have this sort of street mentality of, No matter what happens, you shouldn't cooperate with law enforcement. And, you know, there can be no eyewitnesses to anything, and crimes never get solved because people have this sort of mentality. I do not support that. So I absolutely support anybody that decides to turn against these groups that are causing so much havoc in society. They are not needed. They're absolutely useless. We have no use for them. They do not make any positive contribution to society. And I see adults that support this kind of lifestyle, and they are, tearing down. They are trying to tear down Tekash's image by saying, well, he shouldn't have joined if he couldn't keep to it. No, how about we support anybody that decides to turn against these groups? Because these groups should be dismantled and they should not exist to begin with. That's what you should support. It really baffles me that people still do not understand that this whole loyalty thing amongst these groups make no sense and it is non-existent. They want to believe that there's a lot of loyalty between them because they took some stupid oath and they were initiated and they're just really loyal to each other. But there is no loyalty. So if someone is coming after you and your family and everything that you care about, you have no loyalty to them. And I understand that people are saying, well, if you're going to handle it, you need to handle it within the group. You shouldn't go out to law enforcement and rat people out. Well, the thing is, he was in a position whereby his family was being threatened. He could either speak up and go back home to his family, where he can better protect them, or he can be quiet and inadvertently protect the people that are about to attack his family. So it made no sense for him to decide to keep quiet and protect these guys. He wasn't trying to go and commit a whole bunch of violence by himself. So he went about it in the way that he believed was best for himself, for his family, his future. And if you don't think that that is the smartest thing that this guy could have done under those circumstances, then honestly, I really question your judgment. And I wish you success in life, because this is very clear to me. And then we have somebody like Meek Mill, who isn't he in his 30s now? If he isn't, he probably is almost 30. And here he is having an emotional breakdown over Tekashi, who's many, many, many years younger than him. He's angry at Tekashi because Tekashi dared to pull what so many people that were quote unquote raised in the streets do not have the nerve to do. This guy mingled with both groups and got out, told on them to the police, had some of them serving prison sentences. He's back home, no longer in prison, and people cannot take it. Well, the fact is, he is smart enough to say, these people are of no use to me and I am out. And honestly, I cannot commend him enough for this. I'm hoping that some of these people that are still parts of these kinds of groups will smarten up and begin to learn when to take the high road and just say, you know what, forget all of this. I am out of this. But obviously, that's never going to happen, because they will continue to say that people that think the way that I think, we do not understand the streets and we weren't raised in the streets and we don't understand the code. But it's not that people don't understand the code. It's not that I don't understand the code. I do understand the perspective of these people. What I'm saying is, it is good to know when to bail, when to get out. When it's good to recognize when something no longer serves you and say, you know what, you are extremely disloyal to me, so I am going to be disloyal back to you. And here's the thing, if you're loyal to someone and they decide to be extremely disloyal to you in every way possible, they do not get to dictate how you can be disloyal back to them. They no longer get to dictate your actions. You can do whatever you think is best for yourself. And extract yourself out of the equation and make the most of it, which is what Tekashi is doing. And I'm glad that his music is successful. I'm glad that he took the route that he has taken. And I hope he does not let all of this nonsense that people are saying with them attacking him and calling him a rat, I hope he doesn't let it get to him and change his mind, because I honestly believe that he's doing the right thing. And whoever that girl is that ratted out his address, I hope that she is arrested. I hope that she serves some serious time, because technically Tekashi is still serving the rest of his sentence. So what she's basically doing is she is pointing out to people that are trying to do serious harm to him where he lives. Like, he's giving them their address so that they can do serious harm to him. And I hope she is arrested. I hope she faces some serious consequences so that she knows not to discourage other people from going to law enforcement when they need to. And this childish mentality of, well, we don't do police, we don't talk to the police, that is childish, that is ridiculous, that is very, very unintelligent, and I can't even relate to that. So I hope she suffers some serious consequences, and I hope she gets to pay some serious fines, like court fees and whatever cost that was incurred in relocating Tekashi to his new place. I hope she is forced to take responsibility of that so that she can learn her lesson, and she would be an example that whoever tries to do something like this will change their mind, because this does a lot of damage. You know, it scares people from, like, when you cooperate with the police and you put people like these guys, like Shoddy and all these other guys, and you put people like those that are causing harm in society behind bars, and then the whole society is coming after you as if you actually did something wrong when you didn't, and you have a girl, a random girl, who's giving away your address so that people can come harm you. Stuff like this can discourage people from going to law enforcement. So she's doing a lot of damage, more damage than she realizes, and I hope that she suffers some very, very, very serious consequences in the hands of the law. Possibly she needs to serve some time so that she knows that this whole thing is not a joke, and, you know, and that will deter other people who try to give away Tekashi's address. Not just Tekashi's address, but whoever cooperates with the police. I feel like those people should be protected in some ways, because they are doing good. However you want to look at it, they are doing some good. And as much as people want to say that he's being treated fairly by the courts because he's not black, well, the thing is, compare the way that he behaved in the courtroom to the way that Shoddy, for instance, behaved in the courtroom with his chanting, "We don't bend, we don't fold, we don't whatever." I mean, if you're acting that way, you cannot ignore your own behavior and put the whole thing on the color of your skin. I'm not gonna say that race doesn't play a hand in a lot of the things that go on these days. However, sometimes we have to look at our own behavior as human beings and say, okay, how is that person acting differently from me, and how is that affecting how other people treat the both of us? And in this case, I think that his behavior had a lot to do with it. He was very, very cooperative. He was so cooperative to the extent where he was being made fun of by the judge and by everyone, literally, with all the memes and everything. But it paid off in the end. And I just hope that he's safe, his family is safe. And this childish mentality of you shouldn't rat some horrible, terrible, murdering people to the police, that's just ridiculous. I do not agree with that at all. Anyway, that's all I'm saying on this. Thank you for watching or listening, and I will see you in my next one. Bye, guys.